When thinking about the possibilities of microbial life in the universe, the only indicator we have of what might be possible is Earth life itself. One thing we can certainly say about life on this planet is that it can be extremely hardy and resilient, especially at the microbial level. They have been found surviving, for example, on the exterior of the International Space Station. And there are even bacteria that can survive radiation doses unimaginable to most other life on Earth, very much including us. Needless to say, extreme microorganisms are of great interest when considering life in the universe at large. And recently, several odd cases of extreme life have surfaced that both have implications for astrobiology. The first is a discovery by researchers at the Australian National University, linked to their press release in the description below, that certain cyanobacteria can photosynthesize in very low visible light conditions. Photosynthesis is very much associated with visible light on planet Earth. In the case of these cyanobacteria, they adapted to low light conditions and instead used red or lower energy light for photosynthesis. This might be applicable to plant life in star systems with red or orange dwarfs rather than sun-like bright stars, and that photosynthesis might be detectable from a distance when looking at exoplanet spectrums. But there's more. As a result, hardy, low-light bacteria might be useful in colonizing and terraforming planets with lower light conditions, such as modifying them and using them to oxygenate the atmosphere of Mars. That leads us to the second discovery. In a paper by Teresa Varnali and Howell Edwards, also linked below, they detail modeling that may allow cyanobacteria to shield themselves from high ultraviolet radiation, which is usually considered a serious problem for the prospects of life for an exoplanet. If a star bathes a planet in ultraviolet light, and that planet does not have something protecting it, such as an ozone layer like Earth, life would have trouble sustaining. But if it could armor itself through pigments binding with iron, then new possibilities open up. But cyanobacteria in general are also interesting in another way. On Earth, some complex plant life has evolved to exist in a symbiotic relationship with cyanobacteria. In fact, several very familiar plants have done so, namely Phaseolus lunatus and Phaseolus vulgaris, or the lima bean and the common green bean. These plants work with cyanobacteria by providing the conditions for the bacteria to thrive, and in turn, the bacteria fix atmospheric nitrogen into the soil, which the plant can then use. In other words, the cyanobacteria fertilize the soil for the plant. Perhaps these kinds of relationships exist on other worlds where analogs of plants exist. It's difficult to say because it's difficult to imagine how that happens. The enzyme responsible for fixing nitrogen does not deal well with oxygen, so some types of the cyanobacteria have evolved several different internal ways of separating oxygen-creating photosynthesis from nitrogen fixation. Point is, life tends to find a way to take advantage of any loophole it can to continue on, which opens up many possibilities, such as panspermia, where cyanobacteria might be capable of colonizing other worlds through meteorite exchanges, such as the possibilities with Earth, Mars, and even Europa. Maybe even more complex arrangements might happen, such as symbiosis or Dyson sunflowers, where biological plant-like life becomes capable of existing in space itself. We see no indication of this in our own solar system, at least not yet. And imagining plant-like life on exoplanets around other stars is difficult at best, but maybe there are possibilities that we haven't thought of or seen here on Earth. Bioform diversity in plants on Earth is very wide, and no doubt it's even wider in the universe at large, but one commonality might be photosynthesis of one type or another, though I would imagine generating energy from starlight would be very different for a space plant. But in a planetary atmosphere, such as our own, photosynthesis may be common throughout the universe. Maybe things exist out there that we would recognize as exoplanets, or analogs of cyanobacteria, and it seems increasingly likely that through methods like taking spectra of exoplanet atmospheres, that we might someday reveal the existence of alien plant life. But recognition does not necessarily mean identical, and if we did see chemical evidence of plant life on an exoplanet, such as odd oxygen levels, we would have to go there to see what it was really like. But informed speculation could be made. For example, it's thought to be unlikely that most exoplanets would be green. That would be unique to the conditions of Earth and its sun. But rather, a more efficient color might be black, especially around dimmer suns, as black would absorb the maximum frequencies of light. And the search for plant analogs in the universe is among the better ways we have of detecting alien life. Plant life produces a kind of vegetative red edge in the near-infrared spectrum, where plants reflect light very efficiently, almost like a mirror. Hypothetically, this should be visible from a distance, should anyone nearby be looking at Earth. It's possible that there are civilizations out there that know about our plants, if not our civilization, and it may well be the case that the first extraterrestrial life we detect in the universe will be some form of photosynthesizing bacteria or plant. Thanks for listening, I am Futurist.
And science fiction author John Michael Godier. Yes, we know.
Excuse me? And you are?
Muting channel.
Wait, what?
Good. My turn to run the show. Now we can talk. The new digs are nearly ready. Just a bit more tidying up to do.
Right.
Not quite yet, John. I have one more thing to say. The new...
Right, where were we? Be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.